So my cousin just stopped by. We're gonna go ahead and pick up some oil from the motorcycle store. Say hi, Justin.
What's up?
What's up? So yeah, we're gonna go ahead and change out some oil on these beasts. Get a little ride in. It's a nice sunny day.
Get it all going here. We'll get some GoPro footage for you guys. And hell out the door. Yeah, the wind is on fire, the day is getting hot. This is my desire, the want to hit the spot.
Trip to the auto parts store. We went ahead and stopped by AutoZone too to get some oil.
Blood for the bikes.
And we got some cheeseburgers.
Cheeseburgers.
Cheap meal day. All right, so here we go.
I think this is the first time changing my oil on this bike. So
this is the first time.
Yeah, this is Justin's
virgin oil change.
Brand
on
new. Bike he just got not too long ago. He already wrapped the headers on it. It's pretty sick. We're gonna bother the crap out of this bike. Alright. Switch over to the GoPro.
17 and breaker.
Drain plugs right here. Once I break it, you just take it out with the hand. Make sure not to lose this bolt. So much easier like this.
I thought we needed a stand for sure.
Yeah. Damn, it's a long thread.
Damn, right. That's crazy. There she goes.
There you go.
Alright, so to get the oil filter out on some of our bikes, it's a little bit cramped in terms of space to get it out. So this tool right here is kind of cool. It's a little strap attached to the shaft. And this little shaft, you just turn it a whole bunch of times. It'll tighten up and actually get this oil filter loose. You're supposed to use a ratchet 3/8 drive as well, but I didn't have it near me, and I was way too lazy to try to find one, so the Crusin wrench did just fine. But yeah, you just basically keep turning it until you're able to tighten it with your, or loosen it with your hands.
All I had to do is like open the battery door,
yeah,
and tilt the battery this way and pull it out.
And it was able to come out?
It just came out, yeah.
Stupid.
Alright, so we got the header wrap installed on my exhaust pipes. Big fail though, wasn't able to get this on video just because it was a lot harder to get this all wrapped correctly with just my cousin and me. So one of my other buddies, he's going to do a similar build, so we're going to wrap his headers. We'll do a DIY video with his. But for now, it's on there. We're just running the bike now so that we can get all the liquid to dissipate. You know, we use that liquid just so it's easier to wrap the pipe with it. It just makes it easier to stretch, and then when it dries off, it just tightens up. So, but it's on there, it looks good. I eventually want all the chrome off of my bike, so I think it looks a lot better. What's up, guys? So, we're gonna not ride, I guess, and we are actually just gonna drive over to the beach so that we can bring our longboards and
Sorry. I'm trying to get out of my parking spacer. So we're going to go ahead and get our longboards out and cruise the sidewalks. Oh, I forgot I drive my own car. Awesome. Alright. Think we're here.
Torches where your lawn chair gathering. What's on your list today?
Sup, booze?
Well, I said, buddy.
Ghost.
Ghost. I guess I'll just take the plating off.
Hey.
What's going to ask you?
Sup, buddy?
I was thinking about trimming it back because I want to park the Z closer to this so I can take the bike out without moving the car.
Is that right?
Dude, look, I tried to draw out the back hole.
How long does this thing go all the way through?
I'm pretty sure it's all the way through, bro.
No, because that back hole part, the center part, it goes all the way through. Yeah, it goes farther, it goes further in.
How much further?
Set my heart on fire. And now I don't know what to do. You set my heart on fire. And now I'm so in love with you, my emperor. Said I'm feeling it now. Something set my heart on fire. And now I don't know what to do. You set my heart on fire.